Would like to know, it was regarding the data. This is there in my file one, employee ID and name only. Okay.
Okay.
In second file, I kept employee ID, city, DOB and salary.
Okay.
What I imagine to do, like I will join both of this input file
okay.
based on employee
Okay.
ID, and in my output file it will contain generally all the fields.
Okay.
That's called your name and city, DOB and all other things.
Okay, sure. And how many records you have? You are using only 10 records or something?
5 and 6 records only.
Okay.
And this component also, Karthik, it's sort within groups. I just was trying to do, like, I define major key and the minor key. Okay. But while.
Yes, okay. You have defined major key, right? Does the input be sorted in major key, that is employee ID, when it is coming out of join?
This, I have made it ordered true here in our join component. Maintain order true. So
maintain
I was
order
expecting.
Yeah, maintain order doesn't guarantee that your input output records are sorted. It maintains the order, because if the first record, that means if there are two records from input file 1, and those two records will be in the same order as they appeared in your input flow 1. It doesn't guarantee that it will sort the records after joining. If there are two records and they appear as second record and sixth record, they will appear as the same in your output record. It doesn't sort. So you cannot guarantee that maintain order sorts the record. It just maintains the sort order. And for sort between groups, your input must be sorted.
Okay. So that might be the reason. Okay, we will check it. What happened?
Yeah.
Even if I run it, you can see the error.
What is the error? It's going out of order data.
Yes, it's saying like sorting groups partition 0.
The first thing is right. Record 5 is out of order with respect to the previous group of
It means it's not getting data in sorted order, right?
Yeah. So remove that.
So to resolve this, I will do. I need to have a sort component added here.
Yes. So ultimately, your input records must be sorted before using that major key and minor key here. And it doesn't make sense if you are sorting the records and again you are using sort within groups. You can do that very well using sort component with groups. Right?
Yes. Then, Karthik, it's just curiosity to know for me. Like if sort within groups doesn't make a sense, because the same we can achieve through sort, okay, then what is the, then why they have given this component?
If you do not want to alter the input sorted flow, in that case you can use sort within groups. If you know that your input records are sorted in one field and you want to group the records in that field, again, you can use sort within groups. If you know that your input data is already sorted coming out of in your source, you can use sort within groups.
Okay. performance wise, if we add more and more component in my graph, a single graph, does it makes the entire graph costly in sense of CPU utilization?
Yes, somewhat, yes. But each component has got its own max score. And if you're adding more components, means you are increasing the memory usage of the graph. So it's better to limit the components and use the components functionality to the code so that your requirement is really solved. You better try to achieve the result with less number of components. Okay? Okay, to check this, remove that component and connect it to the output file. Okay,
We are going
now,
to check the XPs.
okay, explicit join, okay. Go inside join and give the parameters for left outer join so that all your records in input file 1 will appear and the missing records and the matching records from input file 2. So make record required 0 to be true and for record required 1 to be false. Yeah, here the next
Yeah, that.
parameter. Here you can select explicit join. You select explicit join, two parameters will appear. Okay, record required 0 and 1. If you are going to perform left outer join, make the record required 1 as false because you need all the records from first flow, right? That is the left flow. Here left flow in the sense input file 1, that is in 0. Okay, now go back to the transform. I want to see what you have given. First defined out in 0 dot employee ID comma in 1. Okay, good.
Here I just tried to do one thing, Karthike. When I made your full outer join, okay, then
Okay.
one employee ID was coming null. So I used this
Okay.
first defined function so that at least I would know which employee ID didn't have matching records.
Okay. Sure.
Is this
And
fine?
yeah, yes, this is fine. And you are getting all the fields from in 1 as well as in 0. Okay.
Sorry,
Go back. Yeah. Save this and run the
Sorry.
graph. Save and run the graph. So since we have 5 records in input file 1, the expected output is 5 records. We don't get more than that. Okay? And open the second input also.
Okay.
Open the second input. So you got the correct result.
When we this thing, what we have done, like we used the explicit, and it was left outer join, right?
Yes.
Left outer join means all the records from the first file and corresponding matching records from file 2, and other records we are ignoring from file 2.
Yes.
Okay, because in file 2 we have a record called 51 that was not coming here. least regard. You can't know why.
Okay.
So, okay. So, this time, if we do the reverse,
okay.
And if you keep both false, then Kartike?
Yeah, I will get back to that later. Yeah, I will get back to that later. Have you experienced the right outer joining? Yeah. So we have 6 records. Open all the input data side by side so we can check the records. 3 data.
We can we look from here directly?
Drag it out. Okay. That's it. The output error. So now, since we have provided right outer join, all the records from your 6 records, that is all that is present there, will be there. 6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 4. If you have a match for 6, then all your records, other fields.
Uh-huh.
So you are selecting name from there, right?
Uh-huh.
6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 4. For 1, you don't have a corresponding name. So we are getting null uh-huh. there. For other fields, uh-huh. you are getting the correct names.
Yes.
Okay. Now mm-hmm. keep this windows the same. Go back, click the graph outside. Yeah. You can work on your graphs directly without closing these windows. Now okay, you experienced full outer join and
yes.
are you clear with the output?
This one, previously whatever we did here with the explicit join type, the same we have achieved with outer join, okay, full outer join.
No, I'm not getting you. Full outer join means you will get all the records from
both files,
okay,
and null for the non-matching records.
Yes, okay, good. So
then
now
similarly,
I have a question for you. Yes, sorry.
Similarly, we have got the same result when we have made these changes. That is right outer join, right?
Yeah, but you cannot say like they are same, because full outer, it means matching records as well as all the other records from both files. So if it is left
okay.
outer from one file, right outer from the other file, okay?
Okay, I got it. Exactly, both have exactly these two have same. This input file one has all records which file two have. That's why I don't experience it. Okay, I got it.
Okay. Now, if you keep both as false, what will happen?
Mm-hmm.
Or both is true? Let's try that. We're asking records to be required on both ports. So what will happen? What type of join will occur here?
It will be full outer join. It will be full outer join.
Full outer join? Okay, let's check.
Why I guessed it? Because if we make it true, that means all records from file 1. And when
mm-hmm.
we make it true, second one, then all records from file 2. So it
mm-hmm.
makes, that means it is full outer join. If we are keeping
okay.
the first number.
Okay. Let's check.
Shall I increase some data? No.
Second. Yeah, you have already opened the window, right?
Okay. Yes.
Just to refresh the report. What type of join you have got here? Is it full outer or some other thing?
It's your left outer join.
Get the input data, two data. Check what type of join you have got. Six is there, seven is there, eight is there, nine is there, four is there.
So it's a left outer join.
Is it full outer join?
No.
Okay.
It's
what
left
you
outer
have got
join.
Is left outer? No. Left outer means where is? No, singular only. Oh, okay. It's not left outer join actually happening, actually it's inner join. You get all the matching records.
One second, Kartikeya. I just want to change the data here.
Okay, sure. Run the graph and you can refresh the files, the windows. So the graph is completed. Tracking that's it. Refresh your input file.
So these two are non-matching records, that's why it has not come. So when we made true, it acted as inner join.
Yes, this is an interview question. So when you use explicit join and when you set both the record repair parameters are true, what type of join will happen?
Inner join, okay. And we don't have this option as default. Like we can only achieve through explicit join, right?
No, it's the inner join, right? Inner join we have the option.
Yeah.
However, don't confuse yourself. So we have three types of join. First one is inner join. We get all the matching. Okay. And second one is full outer join. We get the matching records as well as other records from your both input fields. That is full outer join. And third one is explicit join. Either we can do a left outer or a right outer. Okay? And to perform this left outer and right outer, we have two parameters. Record required 0 and record required 1. In that, if you make both that parameters as true, then it will behave as inner join. Okay. And let's check what happens if you make both the parameters as false. Can you guess what will be the output?
Right, should be full.
Yeah, in the parameter itself, it's specifying, right, use null for missing records. Where you will use nulls?
It will be full outer join, null for non-matching records.
Yes. Run the graph and check. Refresh the output file. Yeah. Same. You got it right. 6, 7, 8, 9, 4. We have a match. 0. We have name only. The other fields we have got null. 4, 4, 9. Same thing. So 5, 1. That's from the second file. So we don't have ID or name here. Since you have handled the ID by in the transform function, we are taking the ID from first file and name. It's null. So the other things you are getting. Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, Gartike, I would just recall everything in brief what we did here. Like in join, we have three options. One is inner join, okay, where only matching required will come. Second is outer join, where matching, non-matching required will come and null will be populated for non-matching records.
Yeah.
Okay. For explicit, we have two options. And if explicit, we can, if we make the both parameters true, it's inner join. If we make false, it's outer join. Okay. And other two options what we have, like if we make one true, like first true and second false, then it will be left outer join.
Okay.
And if we make second true and first false, it will be our right outer join.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Correct. Oh, that's fine.
And let's take the other case studies. Or you want to try some other parameters?
Yes, I wanted to just finish everything from the join. Like I should not have any more confusion. This I have already explored. In key, I can mention 2 and 3 keys to join, right?
Yes.
Okay, and Kartike, here if I say in Oracle we normally do suppose we have table A and table B.
Yes.
I don't know why you can see it, no? Okay.
Yeah.
We have two files and suppose this is the same file we are handling, then we do it like a dot emp id space to b dot emp id.
Okay.
It's our left outer join, right?
Yes.
In Oracle. If we make it like this, it's our full outer join, correct?
Yeah.
It's our inner join, correct?
Okay.
But if we have two columns, say the same here, if we are joining on EMP ID and say DOB, it's hypothetical situation, but just for understanding, I'm just asking.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this kind of join, it's possible to achieve here. Like I wanted full outer join on one column and inner join on second column.
No, I think no.
We cannot,
yeah. You're asking in Oracle or ab initio here?
In Oracle, it's possible in ab initio also.
No. You have selected a key and you want to perform a single join. You can't perform two joins at once. You want to do that, perform the first join and then perform the second join next. So that will be two join components.
But Kartike, we okay, that is one solution. But how we will handle once we have joined that two files, okay, the data will be coming in a single flow, correct?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Now, from this single flow, how would I again join it?
You have to create the second file again, right? If you want to again, you want to join. Join at the basic cells, you are going to join two input flows. So, you have joined first, so join the two input flows and got a single output. Again, if you want to join with another input flow, get that input flow again.
We can do like this, right?
Yeah, yes.
Okay.
So it depends upon the requirement whether you want to join again.
Okay. But that's not possible in a single join, what I just expected,
no.
Right? Okay, Patrick. We can move to the next.
Okay. So for the other two case studies, getting this every fifth record and getting a percentage of the records. What component you are trying to use?
The component that came in my mind that was in transform, sorry, it's not transform, your reformat component I was just trying to use. But I didn't get idea like can we achieve it.
We can achieve this using sequence generator. So the basic approach is
which component?
Sequence of records. So wherever you can use your sequence, because basically these two case studies you want to reduce the number of output records, correct? So if you get that means you are going to do a filter, right? Yeah. So use your sequence generator in the filter by expression component to limit the number of records. You can, I already told you, you can use the sequence generator along with any calculations. So try if you can do that. Yes, get the same input file, the first file, make a copy and then single file.
Filter by expression, it will only accept a single input file.
Yes, try to join.
Sorry?
Try to put the second input flow there. No, I'm asking, try to connect a second flow in the same port. Yes, you can. So wherever you have, if you mouse over within the input port, if you get a gather, now we specify this, okay, get a filter expression new. New component from the organizer.
Sorry?
Get a new filter by expression component from the organizer. Also over near the input port. It's coming like gather, right?
It's coming like a plus sign, like we can have multiple input flow here.
It will come like gather. Get a sort
gather
component here. Yeah. Get a sort component here. I am not able to see, that's what I am asking you to check. Mouse over near the input port. So it's not coming. Okay, wherever you will get, so it will be like open brace, that is the open square bracket, colon, gather written all over it. So wherever you will have this, you can connect multiple input ports. Okay?
That thing is not coming here.
Yeah, it's not visible here. You can check in your office, right? Get a short component, to try to mouse over near your input port, it will come like in gather. So wherever you have this gather input, the gather is a departition component used to collect multiple incoming flows, right, and convert it into a series. So wherever you have gather port, there you can use multiple input flows. Okay.
Yes.
Now here, first try with the single input flow, and try to get the every fifth record in your output. Remove the two components and the second input file here.
We can deselect it, right?
Yeah, disable. Okay.
No.
Click again. Just right click that component and disable. Okay. Now, inside the filter by expression. So, how will you generate your sequence?
We have in next in sequence concern here.
Okay. Yeah, I will try to do this. Okay. Click edit. Okay. I have a question for you. How nesting sequence works? So what values it will give for the incoming records, so that you can get the answer. I want to get the answer from you. That's what.
Next in sequence, what it returns, right?
Yes.
It will start with value 1 and it will keep increasing by 1 till last record.
Till last record. So if you have 10 records, what will be the output for next sequence? For every record?
It will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay. It will return for 1 to 10. Okay.
Yeah,
so if we want to get every fifth record out of my input flow, so what should I do now? Think now.
I will have
to. You have
to
this sequence,
yeah.
And you have to filter only the fifth record and tenth record, right? Suppose, okay.
Yep.
Consider like we have 10 input records and you want to get every third flow, the third record. So how will you get 3, 6, 9? You have to select only 3, 6, 9, right?
Yes, Kartike.
Every third record,
yeah. I think we will have to use some mathematical function here. Like we will have to divide the sequence, and if the remainder is zero, only those records you will select.
Exactly. Next in sequence is available in miscellaneous. Don't always go for this, try to memorize some functions. Yeah. Now, so this, whatever you have given now, this will return 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay? So you have to limit the number of flows.
Yes.
So that you will get the correct output.
You want me to limit the number of records,
yeah,
right?
That's what I want you to get every third record. So how filter condition works here? So for whatever the condition I'm giving, if it returns 1, then that record is selected, right? So I have to make this function return 1 for third record, right? How will you divide and get you a remainder? There is an operator for that. What is that operator to get your reminders?
This is what I'm just
your approach is so correct. So if I'm dividing 6 by 3, I will get remainder 0, right? Yeah, how will you get that remainder value instead of the quotient value? So you have to use modulus operator. Modulus operator is percentage symbol.
Okay, we don't need to use the functions, right?
I think no. Which function you are trying to use?
I was just looking at it.
With nesting sequence, modulus 3. Okay.
It's equals to it should return 1 if my remainder is 0, right? Then we don't need to use if condition.
It's upon your logic. Either you can use it.
Sorry. Not required.
Double equal to. So what you have given, try to think the logic again. You are dividing by 3. And then you are returning, so this modulus will return the remainder. Okay. I will tell you what will happen for the first record, so that you can guess the output.
One second, Karthik. Yeah. Here, this calculation will return the remainder, right?
Where? You can tell me one here, by one.
Okay.
For the first record. Yeah.
It's 1&3. Okay.
Okay. It's one not, modulus 3 will give.
It will be null value.
I think it will give 0 at this. I'm not sure. Okay.
We will check. So if we come to the third record, that is a valid scenario here.
Okay.
So third with reminder is our remainder is 0 here. Okay. So the outcome of this function is 0.
Okay. Whether 0 is equal to 1.
Okay. Now it's fine. Okay. It's okay.
Okay. Change the output file name so you will not mess up with that joint file name. Yeah. Filter every nth record. File name.
Do we need to put the sequence here also?
No. The error was it has conflicting record formats. Yeah, in the output file 2, I think propagate is not enabled. Output file last. Output file.
It's fine.
Output file. Check the output file, not the filter by expression component. There, go to quotes. Use propagate from typos. Here use join type. So if you get an error like this, conflicting record formats, you can check the output. It will show actually which quotes are having conflicting record formats.
I think it's not working here.
Expected token, key. Go back to your filter. Put a space after modulus operator, before that, okay. And enclose this in a bracket.
Just a numerical value?
Starting up to 3. Not here. From starting up to 3. Enclose that in the bracket.
Yes. Like this?
Yes. Perfect value.
Yeah, the same
thing.
I think here the modulus operator, it's not coming here.
Okay, first check whether the modulus operator is here in this. Go back to the expression editor window. Check the operators, arithmetic operators, I guess. Yep, you have one. You have it right? Give me control once and check.
The entire graph. Skip it.
Here you got the records from 4, right? You got the last 4 records. Correct?
Kartike, your voice.
I don't know what's the problem here. It's not accepting any operator after modulus, that argument. Try plus argument. Plus is okay. Something.
Okay, Kartike, I will check it now. I understood the way. Okay, I will check it.
Yeah, I will get back to you. Okay? I'm not sure
yes.
Why it's not accepting the arguments after this. And the other thing, getting 75% of records, there also you have to go by this approach only. Limiting
I will
the
do
number
it.
Of records.
I will do
right?
it.
Yeah. Okay. And you have any, yeah, you can have the control now. Do you have any doubt in join component?
No, no.
Okay. Suppose, go back to your input files in the join. In the second input file, go to the record format. Suppose, replace that employee ID with ID.
The override keys, exactly.
So, what should we do is this? Try to execute the join component, but execute the graph. What it will do. So, you can have it, no problem. So you have to see what error the join is showing. Employee ID not found in that other book, right? Okay, so you have to override this using override key parameter. Double click.
It's done.
Yes. All the other things, all other things will remain same. Now go to the transform function. I think you have used employee ID somewhere. First define now in one dot ID. Okay.
Okay, that's fine. We have two keys, and if it's non-matching, we will do it.
Yep, and the other things also, we can filter the inputs, you can select, you can remove the duplicates, you can use some
D2. Excuse me, Kartik.
So these things you can do.
I have also heard about the surrogate key. What is that?
Surrogate key is a unique identifier along with the primary key. So it will be like a sequence numbers. Surrogate key will only be populated with the sequence number is used to uniquely identify your records. So that will be used during loading.
Database loading, right?
Yeah, yes. So just Google it out. Or in which way you have to use surrogate key. So suppose if you are in need to generate a surrogate key, what will you use now? To generate surrogate keys for a table or a file.
Just the next in sequence function we will use to generate a sequence key.
Yeah, yes. So surrogate key, they are just both sequence numbers.
So these are the unique numbers that we can put in output file record.
Yeah, yes. So it will be sequence numbers starting from 1 to 10 byte. It will be unique.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Okay. Now let us see some other components.
In this category.
Yeah. Can make me the presenter again. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. they may have completed sewing. Max score it defines the value of maximum memory usage for that particular component. If that component is,
how would I determine like what max score value shall I use? Because when I'm running a graph on,
actually you don't need to specify a max default max score value. So every component has got its own max score value by default. In rare cases, you would need to increase or decrease that value. If you increase the max score value, then your graph memory usage will increase and performance will also increase. But it doesn't mean like you can put the max score value to the largest. So in that case, you will use up all your resources and your performance will start to degrade after 1 point. If you keep your max score value very low, then your graph will take more time to execute. So it's better to keep the max score value as optimal as possible and to use the default value which is present there. In rare cases, you will be needing to increase the max score value. Suppose if you have a large amount of file, the max score value, default max score value for sort is I think 96 MB. It can sort up to file sizes ranging from less than 1 GB or something. So if you get a large file size and you want to sort the records, 96 MB of memory is not enough. In that case, you can increase your max score value if your sort component is functioning very low. So when you will need to increase your max score value, so that kind of error specification will be specified in the output window. So I'm like this. So increase your max score value to increase this graph performance. So that like how your error will be there. So according to that, you can increase your max score value. The maximum value is 2431 minus 1. If your component is running in parallel, the value of max score specifies the maximum memory usage per partition, not the sum of all partitions. Okay? And error tolerance. Error tolerance, in this concept, we will be seeing reject threshold parameter, the usage of reject threshold to control the number of errors and failures. Here, for every transform component, there will be a reject threshold parameter. You can see yourself in your join component itself. If you open your join component, you got this reject threshold, right? And
yes.
Here, you will be having three options. Abort and first reject, never abort, use limit or not. Have you used any of this before or do you know any concepts of this?
I use this kind of concept in OWP, like where we are forcing our graph to fail on first error.
Okay. So that corresponds to abort on first reject and that is the default for every component.
Yes.
It fails, it's the first input record. So if you set never abort, what will happen?
It means it will, we will not be able to find if there is any failure or any bad records present in our input file.
Okay. So the component will not fail the graph. The graph keeps on running.
Yeah.
They are getting the errors, right? Yeah. The null value errors, out of order errors, these errors, they will not come. The graph will succeed, but that record which has happened, which has caused this error, that will be sent to your reject put. So if you set your never abort reject threshold value to never abort, you must connect a file to the file or flow. You must connect the reject flow. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, you cannot collect the rejected records.
Mm.
And the last one. Use limit or RAM. Have you used this?
Limiter ramp I have not used, but I just knew about it. Like we can limit the number of errors. Like we can accept maximum 3 or 4 errors, like that. But not used
Yes.
practically.
We can customize the setting to have a minimal number of errors. Okay. So for that setting, we can use limit and ramp. So if you use limit and ramp setting, if you click on that, ab initio will use this formula to calculate the number of reject events. Limit plus ramp into number of records processed so far. So here I have given some default limit and ramp values. If you give, so you can use, they accept like limit and ramp accepts integer and real values. Based upon your values and according to the result of this formula, the number of reject events are handled. So whatever the value returns, the component will stop the execution after that particular value, after that particular error has happened. So if you are going to give 0, 0 for limit and ramp, it will be 0. So the component will fail after 0 errors. That means it will fail after any error. If you are going to give limit 50, and then if you want to give, you want to reject the records, reject the graph for every 50 errors, you can use limit 50 and ramp 0, setting an absolute limit. We are giving 1 and 0.01 in ramp. We are saying that for every 100 records, if more than one record is rejected, fail the graph. So likewise, these kinds of settings we can apply. Okay? Are you clear with this?
Kartik, can you please hold for a minute? Yeah, just coming. You can't take it, you can listen.
Okay. So next transform component we are going to see is rollup. Rollup is used to summarize the input data according to the key specified. It gives one output record for each group of records according to the key. We can use rollup to get perform aggregation. The normal aggregation functions that can be performed using rollup component. Okay, have you used rollup component before?
Yes, Kartike, I use it. And the purpose was the project, like the requirement was to summarize the call records of a group of people based on a
Okay.
particular is the call records like SMS count, the
Okay.
revenue that is generated from those group of people. and there was also requirement to like where I was asked to just get the aggregate revenue of a particular product, like what is the total revenue earned in this quarter from this particular product.
Okay. And the important parameters in rollup are you have sorted input key and your transform parameter. That's your rollup. So rollup can be operated in two ways: a template mode and expanded mode. If you want to use your normal aggregation functions, you can go for template mode because that's the only mode it supports aggregation functions. If you want to use expanded rollup package with extra customary functions like initializing a temporary variable using that temporary variable inside rollup, you can use expanded mode. You cannot use aggregation functions inside expanded mode. If you just go for normal summarizing of data using aggregation functions, you must use template mode rather than expanded mode. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Depending on the setting of sorted input parameter, rollup behaves in two ways. Okay, so if you set your sorted input parameter to input must be sorted, then rollup sends the last record in every group to the output port. Okay, if you set your sorted input parameter to input must in memory, input need not be sorted. That is, if your input is not sorted, rollup sends an arbitrary record from each group to the output port. Okay, it depends upon the sorted input setting. You got the difference?
Yes.
What record rollup sends?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I will give you an example here. Consider we have a customer transaction file consisting of date, customer ID, amount. So this is my input file. The record format is shown here, date, customer ID, and my requirement is for each customer I want to know the date of first purchase, date of last purchase, and the total amount spent by the customer between those two dates. Okay?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I have some customer input data. I want to get the data first purchase, last purchase, and the total amount. Since you have already worked on rollup, can you tell me how we can do this?
Karthike, that was a long time before.
Okay.
In beginning. I just remember like this was the requirement and I used rollup component.
Okay, no problem. Suppose you have to, so this requirement is like you have to perform summary, right? Summary of the amount, and you are going to perform some aggregation. Date of the first date of purchase, that means your first date, that is your minimum date, and then your date of last purchase, that is where maximum of the dates available. So for these kinds of requirements, you can use your rollup function to perform the aggregation.
Mm-hmm.
So my rollup transform will look like this. For here, so my input data consists of more than one records for each customer, right? And I want to first, before performing any aggregation, I want to group the data according to a key. So in this input data, I should choose customer ID as the key so that rollup groups the records based upon customer ID. So each customer will be in separate group so that each customer's total amount spent can be retrieved separately. So I'm going to give customer ID as the key, and inside that a transform function, I'm giving the transform like this. Customer ID, I'm getting it from the input field in that customer ID. For the first date, last date, and total amount, I have used three different functions. Minimum of in date, maximum of in date, sum of amount. Okay. So if you use minimum, in all the fields, what is the minimum value that will be returned? The same is for max and sum. It will sum all the amount fields in that particular group. Okay, for every group, the amount will be added and will be returned. Rollup sends one output record for each group. Okay. Are you clear with this transform?
Yes.
This is the DML of the output file and the output data. If you see how many customers in this file, since we have grouped the file using ID as the customer key, we will get 721, 888, we will get 3 output records since we have 3 customer IDs here. Okay, we will get 1 record per ID, and in that group you will get all the sum of the amounts and the minimum of dates. You understood why we are getting only 3 records in the output?
Yes, because normally it will form a group. Within group, okay, that group it will select one employee ID.
Yeah.
Okay. And for that employee ID, as per this graph and the requirement, like we wanted to know the minimum and the maximum value spent by that particular,
okay,
person or ID.
Okay.
So that's coming here, right?
Yes. And you have told like Rollup selects one record, right? So how will it select that record? Whether it will select based upon my sorted input parameter. If I said input must be sorted, that means my input is sorted. So which record is sent to the output port for each group?
The first record.
First record? Last record. Rollup sends the last record to the output port from each
group. Why? Why?
It's that behavior.
So normally, okay, so Rollup normally selects the last record from each group, right?
Yes, if your input setting is must be sorted. If your input is not sorted, it sends an arbitrary record to the output group. Okay?
A very common question which normally people ask in an interview, the difference between the Rollup and the scan.
Okay. Are you clear with the Rollup component? Can you go to join? Scan?
Yes, up to this Rollup is done. I'd like to have case study on Rollup.
Okay, sure. Next component is scan. Scan is also used to perform aggregation, but it will perform a cumulative summary of the input records, unlike Rollup. So Rollup, it generates a whole summary of the input records. Scan, it generates a running cumulative summary for each input record. And the basic difference, since you have asked, Rollup, it sends one output record for each group, and scan, it generates an output record for each input record. So if you get 10 input records, you will get 10 output records. But unlike Rollup,
scan component.
Yeah, with scan component. So if you are using Rollup and you are getting 2 groups, you will get 2 output records. Scan, it generates an output record for every input record. Okay? The same parameters are available in scan, like sorted input, key, and transform. So where you will use join, where you will use scan is, suppose you want to generate a running total or a running summary, like successive year-to-date totals. For these kinds of calculations, you will use scan. The normal aggregation functions are also available in scan. Okay?
The requirement is not clear.
If you want to calculate running summary, Running summary of your input data. If you have 2 records and you want to calculate, let me put it this way. I want to calculate the total amount spent by the customer up to this date. Suppose if I have 10 records, how much this guy has spent up to November month or up to February month in a calendar year. So for these calculations, right, how much has spent up to this, including the past as well as the current record. If you want to calculate cumulative summary or the running summary, you have to use scan proper. Rollup, it aggregates all your input data. It doesn't perform running summary, it performs and hold summary. Okay.
I still have doubt, but during case study I think it will be clear.
Yeah, okay. I will give you an example here. Once you see the example, you will be able to do it. Okay. Consider this information. I have a customer ID, date and amount. Okay. And if I use the same transformation that I used for rollup, remember we used we calculated some of the amounts as well as minimum and maximum dates as well as using the customer ID as key. Okay. So under the same care, so if I'm trying to calculate the sum of the transaction amounts for each customer ID. So in this case, I'm going to give customer ID as the key. Okay. So my requirement here would be calculate running totals for customer IDs. So to get an output file with customer ID, date and amount to date. So amount to date is a running summary up to this date, how much he has spent, how much is each customer has spent. So this is my requirement. Okay. Up to this date, how much this guy has spent. If you want to calculate this, you have to use scan component like this. So in my scan transform, I'm giving all the other fields the same ID and date. For the amount to date column, I'm using, since I have to calculate the addition of all the amounts, I'm using sum of amount. So how the output will look like is, see, for 2142 customer ID, I have amount as 52, and then in the June month, he has bought some other items for 22 and there is no record for him. For 213 this guy, there are 3 records, 47 rupees, 221 and 17. So if I use some aggregation on scan component, what will be the output is, a record will be written for every input record. Okay, so if you are having 10 input records, 10 output records will be there. But the exact difference lies in the aggregation calculation here. So the first record, it will be written as such. 2142 has got 52 rupees. And the second record, 2142, these two records will be added up and the amount will be shown as the second record's amount to get. See, 52 plus 20. 32. 74. For this customer. This customer on this date, up to this date, he has spent 74 rupees. Okay.
Okay. And what we have given in the transform function, Karthike, like you just said, like by this month, what is the actual amount spent by the customer?
No, we have not specified anything like that. Just we have specified the sum of amount. If you want to calculate that type of things, you have to then limit your functions calculation to calculate only for this month or that month. So that logic you have to bring it to the scan component.
Okay. So what I got from scan component, like the basic difference lies between rollup and scan. Like rollup will give me record based on group, okay, but scan will give me output of each group. And here in this requirement, what we are going to do, like we wanted to calculate the amount, total amount spent till date. So
Yes.
in March month he spent 52, but when the expenses is calculated in June, it's his total expenses is 74, right?
Yes.
So he, if he had might made some call or any expenses in August month, so what
Yes.
I will have like all it will be like 74 plus expenses of August, the sum of 74 and expenses of August, right?
Yes, yes, you are right.
And this type of output we cannot get in roll-up component.
No, we cannot perform this cumulative summary in roll-up. Because roll-up it gives
okay.
one output record for each group, right? You cannot get multiple output records for the same customer.
Yes, ID. Yes, yes.
So
yes.
based on that reason,
yes.
you cannot calculate that. So that's the basic difference. Roll-up gives one record per group. Scan gives all records in the group. Okay. So
right.
if you want to check other
yes,
customer
yes.
ID.
Kartik,
yeah. Yeah, go ahead.
I would need this example screenshot, Kartik.
Okay, sure. This example I think you have in your help file.
Which file?
Help file.
Okay, I'll be
sure. Yeah, yes.
Oh, okay.
Take the roll-up component in the help file. Roll-up for scan component. And okay, you will see normalized tomorrow. I think it's time.
No, yes, but okay. You just give me the case study for the roll-up and the scan. And and I was just thinking, Kartik, like we have the requirement when we were using the transform function, that is your reformat, like
okay.
we have full name, we have first name, last name, but requirement was to have like first letter of first name and full and then the last name. So such kind of exercise do you have, like whether where we are playing with where we are handling with this type of string functions?
Yeah, you know the functions, right? To perform this, to get the first letter or to get the last letter. Yes, this yeah that's what. For all kinds of functions, if I'm going to give one case study, it will take more than 100, right? I said you. So it's just like we have to know all the functions. So once we know all the functions, you can apply wherever necessary. So it depends upon your logic. And you can get to your logic by using more than one way. I have shown you, right? Whether you can use a string prefix or a string substring. You can generate more cases on your own and try to work on that.
Yes, please.
And for this roll up and scan, okay. You have the employee file, right? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And I want to get, okay. So the requirement is like this. Who is getting the maximum salary for each location? I'm having employee records with different locations. Let's try here. Suppose 100, 30, 25k, Chennai, 10, Ravi, 34k, Chennai, Raj, 14k, If I have input records like this, employee records, I want to point, who is getting maximum salary in each location? This is my recommendation. Okay. So I have to get this Ravi out of Chennai and Ram out of Pune. Okay. Will you be able to do this?
Yes. Yes, Patrick.
Who is getting maximum salary? And other thing would be try to perform. So I am having a sales data, sales input data like this, a date and then date column, amount column, customer ID, get it like this, customer ID, date and amount. So I have to calculate running totals of the amount for each customer ID. Same example which I have shown you here. Running totals for the each customer ID. Try to work on these two. Okay.
Okay, got it.
Let's see tomorrow. Okay, we'll meet up tomorrow.
Yes, got it.
Okay, sir. Okay.
My pen. Bye-bye.